Very good morning, students. Myself Swati Kumari, a student of Jamshedpur Women's College, B.ed 4th semester, will take the maths class for students of Standard 8. Students, before starting with the class, let me ask you few questions based on your previous knowledge. My first question is, what are polygons? Okay. My second question is, what are the different types of polygons? Okay. My third question is, what is the sum of all angles of a triangle? Now students, can you tell me the name of this figure? Students, this is a rectangle. Can you tell me the name of this figure? It's a square. Can you tell me the name of this figure? It's a kite. And what is the name of this figure? It's a rhombus. Now students, these all figures have their own specific name. You all also have your own specific name. But students, you all as together are the group of, belong to a group of students. And you all as a group of students belong to your own school or your college. Students, similarly these objects, these figures, though they have their own specific names, but they all together belong to a group or a family altogether. So students, today we are going to study about these closed four-sided two-dimensional figures called quadrilaterals and the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. So students, our today's topic is quadrilaterals and angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Now students, if I show you this rectangle, it is a quadrilateral, okay? Now students, a quadrilateral is actually a four-sided figure. Okay students, it should be closed and it should be two-dimensional. Now students, you see a quadrilateral has four vertices, that is A, B, C and D. It has four sides and it has four angles. Now students, if I ask you that what is the sum of all angles of this quadrilateral, what you will do? You will add all the angles together and tell me the sum. Now students, all angles of a rectangle are 90 degrees and sum of all angles of a rectangle will give you 360 degrees. Students, if I show you this square and I ask you that what is the sum of all angles of this square, you will again add all the angles and tell me. Students, it is also 90 degrees for a square, so it will become 360 degrees. Now students, a question comes, that is the sum of all angles of a quadrilateral always 360 degrees? Is that so, students? We'll find our answer with the help of an activity, with the help of a model. Okay, students? So students, this is a model on the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Students, here you can see a quadrilateral ABCD. Okay students, now students, what I am going to do is, I will cut the corners of this quadrilateral and make the cutout of angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. Now students, you all can see that this is a circle. Okay students, you know the angle of a circle is 360 degrees. Now students, what I will do is, I will arrange the four cutout of this quadrilateral corner and arrange them around like this. Okay students? Students, just tell me what you can see. So students, we come to know that the vertex of each cutout of this quadrilateral coincides at a point O. So students, such arrangement of cutouts indicates that the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral forms a complete angle, that is 360 degrees. So students, sum of all angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees.
So students, now we will study in detail about quadrilaterals and the angles and property of quadrilateral. Students, you know that a quadrilateral is a four-sided, two-dimensional closed figures which has four vertices and four sides and four angles. Now students, I have made a quadrilateral on the board. I'll explain you what are the adjacent sides of quadrilateral, adjacent angles, opposite sides and opposite angles. Now students, There are four pairs of adjacent sides in a quadrilateral. They are AB, BC, that is AB and BC. Then it is BC and CD, BC and CD. Third is CD and BA, and the fourth is BA and BAB. Now students, adjacent angles. The angles which are over here, A and B, they are adjacent angles, okay? B and C are the adjacent angles. Students, there are in total four pairs of adjacent angles. They are angle A and angle B, angle B and angle C, angle C and angle B, and angle B and angle A. Now students, opposite sides. You all know the opposite sides of a quadrilateral are AB, CD, and DA and BC. So there are two pairs of opposite sides. So it is AB, CD, and AD, CD. And opposite angles. How many opposite angles are there, students? Two pairs of opposite angles. A and C, B and D. A and C, and B and D. About the quadrilaterals. Now we'll study about the angles and property of a quadrilateral. Now students, we'll prove the angles and property of a quadrilateral. Students, let ABCD be a quadrilateral and then we'll join A and C. Then students, over here you see angle 1 plus angle 2 is angle A and angle 3 plus angle 4 is angle C. So we write down angle 1 plus angle 2 will give you angle A as 1, and angle 3 plus angle 4 giving you angle C as equation 2. Now students, we know that sum of all angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So students, if I add all angles of this triangle ADC, what I get? In triangle ABC, angle 1 plus angle 3 plus angle D is 180 degrees. Okay, consider this as equation, okay, 3. And in triangle ABC, what we have? Angle 2 plus angle 4 plus angle B is giving you angle 180 degrees as sum. This is 4. Now students, if I add equation number 3 and equation number 4, what do I get? Adding third equation and the fourth equation, what I get is angle 1 plus angle 3 plus angle D plus 2 plus angle 4 plus B, giving you 360 degrees. Now students, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to angle A. I'm going to use that over here, okay? So angle 1 plus angle 2 is angle A. And students, angle 3 plus angle 4, this angle and this angle is actually angle what? Angle C. So I'll write down. And we have angle B plus angle D giving you 360 degrees. So students, it can clearly be seen that a sum of all angles of a quadrilateral is coming to be 360 degrees. Therefore students, the sum of all angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Now students, let us do one numerical based on the angles and property of a quadrilateral. Students, the question here says that the measures of two angles of a quadrilateral are 115 degrees and 45 degrees and the other two angles are equal. Find the measure of each equal angle of a quadrilateral. Students, in this question, what is given? It is said that the two angles of the quadrilateral are equal and the other two angles are 115 degree and 45 degree. So students, first of all, in order to solve this question, it is supposed that the measure of the two equal angles are x degree. Let two equal angles, or you can say let each equal angle be x degree. Now students, we know that the sum of all angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So students, therefore, sum
of all angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Therefore, 115 degree plus 45 degree plus x degree plus x is equal to 360 degree. Therefore, students, we'll add them to what it is 160 plus 2x is equal to 360. Then it is 2x equal to 360 minus 160. Therefore, it is x equal to 200. So, we have x equal to 100. So, each equal angle of quadrilateral is 100.
So, students, likewise, we have come to the end of today's class. In today's class, we studied about what are quadrilaterals. Then, we discussed the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. And then, we did numericals on the angle sum property of quadrilateral. Students, I hope it is clear to you. Thank you, students.